Nearly a week of progress at Oroville Dam is allowing some normalcy to return for the nearly 200,000 residents evacuated downstream.
Yeah, every time they drop a new load of rock there and they pour new cement and they do more patching, it is shoring up that spillway in the event that we need to use it again, and they're hoping they won't have to.
Joseph Countryman is an engineer with 20 years of experience overseeing reservoirs, including Folsom Dam, during the historic 1986 floods.
We released 130,000 CFS down the American River that year, and its target release is 115,000 CFS. And it was very, very tenuous, very tight. We got through, we didn't break any levees, but there was a lot of distress.
As Oroville continues to stabilize, questions surround the initial failure of the dam's primary spillway.
I've never seen a concrete lined spillway all of a sudden show up with a big hole in the middle of it. Never seen that. It could happen overnight because the velocities in that spillway channel are very high, 50 to 80 feet per second. That's very, very fast. So if something happens inside the spillway that causes just a slight dislocation in there, that high speed water could just start ripping it out.
Near flooding is becoming a valuable lesson.
The young country, you know, we were all about building and almost zero thought about operation and maintenance.
To respect the aging infrastructure protecting Northern California from flood.
If you think about it, a levee is a long dam. Even with the reservoir function perfectly, you're not protected. We're not protected if the levees don't function.
So we can take a look out over the edge.
Congressman Doug LaMalfa is starting a national conversation.
It's more glamorous to do a new thing when you can have a ribbon cutting for that.
About the need to invest in taking care of what we build.
We can have just as good of a ribbon cutting picture on fixing a levee as when you do a new thing.
Oroville providing a sobering reminder of the potential for devastating consequences. Vicki Gonzalez, KCRA 3 News.